ऐसा।
गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू, आई एम मिथिला, फाइनल ईयर स्टूडेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग एट SSN कॉलेज ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट ऑन 3D प्रिंटिंग ऑन कॉन्क्रीट। द कंटेंट ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन आर इंट्रोडक्शन, डेफिनेशन, सो व्हाई टू प्रिंट कॉन्क्रीट, हाउ इट वर्क्स, SLA 3D प्रिंटर, एडवांसेस इन इक्विपमेंट, एडवांसेस इन मटेरियल, स्टील रीइंफोर्समेंट, एप्लीकेशंस, प्रोस कॉन्स एंड कंक्लूशन। So concrete 3D printing is printing is the shiny new tool in the toolboxes of construction companies. It is a part of digital construction process. So what is 3D concrete printing? 3D concrete printing is an additive manufacturing process that creates a physical object from a digital design. It is called an additive manufacturing process because a new material is continually added to it when it wants. The printer intelligently reads the files and lays down consecutive layers of materials. It is a computer-controlled sequential layering of material to produce 3D shapes. It helps to optimize the construction of a building. So how do we define 3D printing in construction? So the Kahn defines 3D printing in construction as transforming an imagination of a facility in whole or in part, depicted through a computer model, into a reality facility with least human involvement and most conservation of natural resources. So why to print concrete? So in this slide, in the first pick, the labor safety is at risk. To reduce the risk, we can use this method. In the second pick, you can see every house around us is simple and same. So to customize our building, we use this method. So in this slide, the first pick, this type of structures can be created using 3D printing. It shows the innovation in design. So in the second pic, you can see the structure is not solid. It has some lattice structure, so less material is used. This type of lattice structure can be constructed easily through 3D printing. So how it works? The 3D image of a model is created using CAD. The software slices the final model into hundreds or thousands of horizontal layers. So the printer creates the object layer by layer, starting from the bottom layer by depositing the material on the platform, as you can see in this picture. So in some cases, lasers are used to harden the material. So SLA 3D printer, it is a type of a 3D printer which is used in the construction industry. The SLA stands for stereolithography. The first one, the laser source, it is the first and foremost a laser source which emits a laser beam. That triangle shape is actually the laser beam. The laser beam helps to solidify the liquid material to form the final 3D dimensional object. The elevator, the second part. So this one, the main function of this elevator is to help lay the layers. This elevator moves up and down, thereby raising and lowering the platform in order to help lay the layers of object. So the vat is the third part. The vat is a vessel-like structure which contains or stores the liquid material. The fourth part is layered parts. This is actual 3D printed object that is created when the material is deposited one by one or in layers on top of each other. So the fifth one, the material, which is actually called resin in case of SLA and DLP printers. This is the subject which is used to create an object. There may be different form of resins used, such as tough resin, dental resin, flexible resin, etc. Today, a lot of different materials are used in 3D printing. Some of the materials used in 3D printing include gold, silver, ceramics, biomaterials, and food. So advances in equipment. To date, both gantry style and robotic arm concrete 3D printers have been successfully implemented, both in research and real world applications. So the left one is the gantry style and the right one is the robotic arm. The advantage of gantry style printers is that they are relatively easy to scale up in size, whereas robotic arms typically have a fixed dimension. However, the speed and degrees of freedom of a six-axis robot allow many complex tasks to be performed that otherwise may not be achievable with the 4-axis gantry printer. So the payload on gantry printer is generally higher than a robotic arm. So the advances in material. Certain advances in the material used in printing concrete has also happened. The cement-based printing inks constitute one of the main pillars for the success of 3D printing of concrete structures. The development of cement-based printing inks that have suitable flowability, extrudability, buildability, and can set rapidly enough to meet the 3D printing process requirements remains a significant challenge in the application of 3D printing in the construction industry. And it has been the subject of active research in the 3D printing of concrete during the last few years. To date, fly ash is used as a substitute for cement. Fly ash is spherical in nature, as it's shown in this picture, and it is easy to flow, because of which the whole structure might get collapsed. So to overcome this, nano clay is used to, along with the fly ash, to avoid the collapse of the whole structure. So steel reinforcement. When 3D concrete printing is fastidiously compared to current methods of concrete construction, a detrimental disadvantage is the absence of effective steel reinforcement. So there are three methods to incorporate the reinforcement in the 3D concrete printing process. So firstly, microfibers made of basalt, carbon, and glass are typically added in the mixing phase, while less workable short steel fibers are entrained during printing through sophisticated mechanism. However, the effectiveness of this technique is limited since the seldom bridge the interlayer interface. So secondly, the longitudinal entrainment of continuous steel cable at the nozzle is a widespread technique. However, it is used in conjunction with the laborious post-tensioning orthogonal to the interlayer interface. Lastly, the use of mesh or needle reinforcement is reported. For mesh reinforcement, increased flexural strength in addition to steel yielding followed by fracture is reported. Currently, most large-scale printed elements are reinforced after printing. So some of the current applications of 3D printing in construction industries are shown in the upcoming slides. So the SIBI in Netherlands, it is the construction of office room in Netherlands using the 3D concrete printing. So this one is actually the structure which is constructed and placed under the road for stormwater collection in France. So Basics 3D, this is actually on famous company which is using 3D concrete printing in Dubai. So this manufactures different types of furnitures. So this Vincent, they provide the cubicle that been constructed for COVID-19 patients in China presently. So the pros. Advantages of 3D concrete printing. So they are the very fast method and it can construct continuously, which reduces the duration of construction period. It is an economic process. It reduces the construction cost by reducing the cost of labors and usage of material. So the increased design flexibility. Cause of this innovation in design can be implemented. Wastage of material is negligible, which reduces the impact on environment. Error reduction, which improves the safety outcomes. In short, this automated manufacturing process has been applied to many diverse fields of industries today due to significant advantages of creating functional prototypes in reasonable build time with less intervention of humans and minimum material wastage. So beside the pros, it also have the cons. So there are no building code, there is no rules and regulations for 3D concrete printing. So finite number of materials can be used since the printer can't able to print the required design in various materials. It have the inability to easily print in multiple materials on the same machine. Transportation of printers to construction site is risky, and at last the energy consumption is more. So as a conclusion, so construction industry is probably the only industry which has been doing additive manufacturing or 3D printing since its inception. So the coming years and decades will witness lots of development efforts on large-scale 3D printers and ink, that is the concrete mixtures for these printers. This presents an opportunity for concrete material scientists to develop new generation concrete mixtures which are strong, durable and long-lasting. So the 3D printing in construction, it will require a workforce with the integrated knowledge of materials, robotics and computer software and hardware. So I would like to thank you, Prayojana and Ashok Kumar sir, for giving me this opportunity to present my report.
Good. Earlier you know about this particular topic, you heard?
No, sir.
No, it is new for you.
Totally new, sir.
You actually made a fully use of it, because you have given a very good presentation on advanced technology which is going to come in future, 3D printing. Because here whatever you are giving in your systems, it is going to be printed, so no manpower required, nothing required. Automatically the robotics and the technology will work. I will show a small video so that you people also will understand. Okay, I am sharing my screen. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Strong, sturdy walls, having a door that we can close at night, it's something that we take for granted, being able to lock our door and be safe. For many of these families, for years, sometimes even a lifetime, they don't have that opportunity to have a safe shelter. So when they move into a new story community, when they move into a safe home, families' lives are transformed.
First product is a 3D printer that can print a house in 24 hours for half the cost. Phase one for New Story and for Icon is a proof of concept house, and the good news is we've done it. We printed the first home in the United States that's going to be permitted. And for us, this is just the beginning. The real kind of home run for us is to be able to do what we've done here in Austin, Texas, in the developing world. We're doing that in what we call phase two, which is in El Salvador. We are going to be printing an entire village for people that don't.
See, the company is saying that they are going to give an half of the cost, and time is also, you can see, within 24 hours they will do this work. So technology is advancing, and if you are coping up with your new technologies, there is a good future. And Nithila, if you wanted, I will give one more topic. You can do a study on that. That is also advanced topic. on a 3D monolithic construction. You heard about this thing?
Yes, sir. Actually, I gave a read about that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Which is the company using that one? Hello?
I don't know, sir.
That in Bangalore, there is a company called Home Mission, and they are into this particular technology where they can see. This is the team, and about the technology, and all the details are available. Advantages, see, like this blocks, it will be made, and it will be just like a building block, it will be assembled. That is the technology. You can see the videos and the work procedures and all, and you can do this as a presentation also. After then I can send to the company also.